What's going on, guys? Today we're going to talk about the uses of DJI drones and the future of the drone industry. Alright guys, before we dive into this video, I want you to think of two uses for drones. Alright, most people think of cinematography or taking photos, but there's a lot of other things that go into the use of drones. So if we look at this chart, we can see things like wind turbine inspection, preventing shark attacks, search and rescue, wildlife conservation, flash flood warning, oil spill monitoring. These are all uses for drones. Some of these might be extreme cases. I don't know how many people are using their drone to prevent shark attacks, maybe here in Miami, but I don't know if that's really a common thing. So we're gonna go into the more common things and talk about some job opportunities with drones. According to Goldman Sachs, we're in the middle of a $100 billion market. So from the year 2016 to the year 2020, the drone industry is projected to have a $100 billion within that market of money spent for jobs such as agriculture, construction, insurance claims, and other things like this. So there are many, many job opportunities in the drone industry outside of purely cinematography or taking photos. Okay, so let's look at one example of that. All right, so as you can see, these workers are using a Matrice 600, which is one of DJI's enterprise drones. So with the Matrice 600, you can mount this Z30 lens. Now the Z30 lens has a 30x optical zoom. And the beauty of that is you don't have to get close to a telephone wire, to a cell phone tower in this case, or to anything that you're inspecting. So for a lot of inspections and this type of work where you had people using cranes or actually climbing up poles and doing it manually just with hard labor, now you can just send up a drone, you can take pictures, you can use thermal cameras or cameras that zoom in like this from several miles away, and you can get very, very accurate readings of what's going on in that cell tower or whatever wire or thing that you're inspecting. So as a result, it's a lot safer. It gets the job done much quicker, and you know, you're really saving lives and making the work more productive. All right, so Goldman Sachs made a list of all the popular job opportunities in the next couple years. So let's go look at that. As you can see, things like construction, agriculture, and insurance claims are top of the list, especially construction and agriculture. So anytime something is being built or something needs to be inspected, you could use a Matrice 600, you could use a Matrice 200 or 210. These drones are really, really popular in that industry. And although they're very expensive, as you can see, a lot of money is being spent in those industries. In the United States and in other countries as well, agriculture is a huge industry for crop inspection. Companies like Monsanto and other really big companies are spending a lot of money for things like a Matrice 200, 210, or an Agras MG-1 so they can spray their crops. It's much more efficient and less time consuming. Now think about all the oil and gas pipelines around the world. They need to be inspected. So DJI drones travel up to 65 miles an hour, so they can cover a lot of territory in a very short period of time. That industry is definitely gonna be growing. We have police and fire, any type of search and rescue or seeing some activity that needs police or fire, Coast Guard, those are all gonna need drones. Journalism, of course, you're doing reporting. Journalists can get different videos and photos that they were never able to take before because of drones. Custom and border protection, or any type of security, you can use drones, especially with thermal cameras people are able to see at nighttime. So at nighttime, you can use a thermal camera to detect if there are anybody out there where they shouldn't be. So real estate, utilities, we talked about pipelines, mining, clean energy, and cinematography. So cinematography is something people think about, and that industry, certainly there's a lot of money, but there's so many other applications above it. Now, things like real estate, pipelines, that involve cinematography and photography. So they put cinematography here in a category by itself, but obviously that applies to a lot of the other categories. One category I didn't see mentioned here was transportation. So a lot of people talk about Amazon or UPS shipping small packages with drones. And they're testing that right now in several states to see if it's gonna work. But right now, the drones don't have the distance in the battery to be able to go to that spot, come back. There's a lot of logistical things that they need to work out. However, it's likely that it's eventually gonna happen. So for DJI, they came out recently with the wind drone. So the wind drone carries anywhere from 5 to 10 pounds. You can put a package or something in there and deliver it. DJI is always on the innovative and latest and greatest technology because they spend a lot of money in research design. So let's talk about DJI for a second. DJI stands for Dà-Jiāng Innovations. In Chinese, Da means big, and Zhang means boundary. So they're talking about big boundaries or big limits to explore, especially with being a drone company. There's a Chinese expression that means great innovations without limits. This is what its founder Frank Wang meant when he started the company. So Dà-Jiāng Inc., DJI, means great innovations without limits. So who is this guy Frank Wang? Well, in 2005, Frank Wang, a student at Hong Kong University of Science and Technology, was given $2,300 from the university to make a drone. All right, so obviously he was a smart guy who's into technology. So he used that money, he made a drone, he worked night and day, and a year later, he was successful with that, and he started the company DJI. Now, obviously this was before the consumer drone market was around. There might've been a few drones, but nothing really popular like it is today. So today, DJI has more than 8,000 employees, but looking back, Frank Wang spent a lot of money and a lot of resources on research and design, R&D. And because of that, he was always able to come out with the latest and greatest technology in drones. So this is why DJI is a leader in the drone market. They control more than 70% of all revenue for the drone industry worldwide, and they're valued at $16 billion. So much like Apple and Samsung that controlled the cell phone market, DJI controls the drone market because they spend so much money on research and design. And whenever another company comes out with a drone that's really good, DJI has another drone in their headquarters, in their design department, that they can come out with and say, look, our drone is better, and then that other company sort of goes out of business or doesn't sell as many drones because DJI's drones are so much better. So for example, this Evo drone that came out was supposed to be a big hit. Now DJI said, all right, that's in the $500 to $1,000 price range. So DJI decided to release the Mavic Air, which is priced at $800 or $1,000 for a combo. And in that same price category, the Mavic Air is better than the Evo. So that sort of put that company on the back burner while DJI raked in more profit. All right, so we've been talking about job opportunities and different drones. So let's look at DJI and the different drone uses. We have over here, we have the Agras, the MG-1, and that's obviously used for agriculture. You can spray pesticide, fertilizer, water, whatever you want to spray on your crops. That does about 7 to 10 acres per hour. So you have to keep changing that container that carries 10 liters of water, whatever you're putting in there, about 2.64 gallons. But it's about 40 times more efficient than spraying by hand. Down below, you have the Matrice 210. This is kind of like the Swiss Army knife of drones. It's one of DJI's most expensive drones. However, you can make a lot of money. All those job opportunities at the top with all the money going to it can be done with the Matrice 210 because it comes with the RTK. You're able to get within millimeter accuracy of a certain point. You're able to do surveying, mapping, inspection of towers, of bridges, of crops, telephone, cell phone towers, all these different things. So the Matrice 10 is very versatile. You can mount two cameras below, or you're able to mount one camera on top, and you can use a 30 time zoom camera. You can use thermal cameras. You can fly this drone in the rain. So it's very, very effective in so many areas. So that's why I call it the Swiss Army knife of drones. So now looking over here with this race car and this drone over here, the Inspire 2, this is the best drone for cinematography. So this drone can fly 65 miles an hour. You can mount a X7 camera and one of the prime lenses so you can get up to 6K footage with that drone that flies 65 miles an hour, has dual redundant batteries, self-heating batteries, so it's just a phenomenal drone for cinematographers. One more thing, the Matrice 210 and Inspire 2 are really great drones because you can fly them in high wind. So they both fly in wind up to about 40 to 50 miles an hour, and you'll still get steady footage. Of course, not everyone's trying to make a living using drones. Some people just want to have fun. So that's why the Mavic Air is so great. It's small, it packs up, it's very portable. You can almost put it in your pocket and just carry it anywhere. There's no really excuse not to carry it. And it shoots phenomenal 4K footage, flies 42 miles an hour, has obstacle avoidance in the front and back. So if it's following you, it won't hit anything. And it also has 8 gigs of internal storage. So that's why this drone, for the price point of $1,000 for a combo with 3 batteries, is one of DJI's most popular drones. All right, so DJI doesn't only make drones, it also makes goggles. This gives you a first-person point of view when you're flying your drone, especially when it's sunny out, you don't have all that glare, and you can get a really immersive experience with the goggles. All right, the Ronin 2 is great for cinematographers. You can walk around, use any camera you want with a ready rig, and you won't get a sore back because all the weight will be transferred to your waist. So you'll be able to film all day. You'll be able to shoot a Hollywood film, basically, with this equipment. All right, so DJI as a company really shines when it comes to stabilization, both for its drones and for things like the Osmo. So the whole Osmo series, it has everything from a Pro to a normal Osmo. Those are both cameras built in, to another stabilizer like the Osmo Mobile here, where you can walk around, put your cell phone on, and just get really stable footage. It also has active track, so it'll follow you around. And a lot of people love this because you can put it down on a base and record yourself. It's like having a cinematographer there for you without actually having a cinematographer there. So now let's look at this video demonstrating active track. Now the beauty of DJI is that it has active track built into all its drones. So in addition to obstacle avoidance and other features and intelligent flight modes, it has a thing called active track. And what that is the drone will actually follow you in many different ways. So it can follow you while going backwards, so you're running forward, for example, like this woman jumping over these boxes, or it can follow you from behind, or if you're hiking with a friend, let's say you want to get a shot from the side, it can also follow you from the side. So it has all different ways of following you automatically, and you don't have to do anything as a cinematographer. And DJI's newest drone, the Mavic 2, especially the Mavic 2 Pro, is probably the best portable drone there is in the world today. And it does everything well, including flying up to 5 miles. It flies up to 31 minutes at speeds of up to 45 miles per hour. And one of the coolest features is a thing called hyperlapse, where you're able to shoot time lapse while flying the drone while moving in the air. All right, guys, I could talk on and on about DJI drones, but I'm gonna have to cut it off here. I know it sounds like I'm plugging DJI, but they're a really innovative company. They're forward thinking, spending a lot of money on research and design, so they always come out with the latest, greatest technology, which I really enjoy as a cinematographer and a photographer. So hope you enjoyed this video, found it informative. If you did, press the like button below. Don't forget to add a comment, share it with a friend, and if you haven't done so, please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it, and don't forget, siempre pa'lante, nunca pa'trás.